Hey, Jason Merle here. If you want to show the price of a stock over a period of time, whether that's weekly or monthly, yearly or multiple years, then the stock chart in Excel is the tool to use. It lets you not only plot the closing price of the stock, but you can also show the high and low points of that stock using what's called candlesticks. Here's what it's all about. So I've got a made up stock here for ABC XYZ company. And depending on what you want to show, I've got two different sets of data here. One showing the open price, the high and the low price throughout the day, and the closing price. The second set of data just shows the highest and the lowest prices and the closing price. So depending on how much data you have or what you want to show on your chart, you can choose one or the other. Let's start with the simplest one here. So this is a formatted table, which means I can select any cell in this table, go to the Insert tab, Waterfall or Stock Chart, and then Stock Chart. There's quite a few options here. You'll notice that the first one says high, low, and close. That's what we're going to use. The next one, as a comparison, is the open, high, low, and close. So that's where you need to use the other set of data for that to represent that information. You can also plot volume prices if you have that information available as well. And these last two options here contain chart types if that's what you need. So for this one, let's just choose the first type there. And because I've got a year's worth of data, you can see that it's really cluttered here. So the first thing I'm going to do is just choose select data at the top, reduce the amount of data down to just 1 week to start off with, just so we can get the chart the way we want it. And after that's done, we can then expand the range of data if we need to. So click OK there, and this is your initial chart. I'm just going to put it on one screen so that the chart is next to your data. Now these things here are called candlesticks, so it shows you the range of data, the price range, that the stock has been at during the day. At the bottom of the stick is the lowest price it reached, top of the stick is the highest price it reached, and halfway along, which you can't see at the moment, is the closing stock price. So if I right-click on any one of these candlesticks and choose Format the High Low Lines, this will display a panel in the right-hand side, and it's taking me straight to the bit I need, which is how I want to format these candlestick lines. At the moment, it just says automatic. Automatic generally means black. The color we can see is down here. If you want to do a slightly different effect, you could choose a gradient line, and that's where it fades from dark to light. And if you look closely, you can actually see the closing price now as a marker, a tiny little marker on each of those candlestick. You can also choose a solid line and choose any color you like for your candlestick. If we change the high-low options here and change it to, say, series close, you have the options here to change either the line or the marker characteristics. I'm going to focus on the marker. And if I start off with the marker options, and where it says built in, you can change the type from a little horizontal dash to a square or a diamond or a triangle or any of these symbols you see down here. Let's maybe choose a square, and let's maybe just supersize it a little bit so we can see it clearly on each candlestick. Just while we're here, I'm also going to set the fill color. So automatic again is just a default color. We can change that to anything we like. And let's turn the border off. And that's how our candlesticks are now looking. So the block is your closing price for the stock. And obviously the candlestick, the line behind each one, shows you the range that the price was throughout the day. If you want to show a trend line for your closing price over 5 days, or if you want to your highest or lowest prices, you can add a line to connect all the dots. So just take any one of these closing price markers, double click it. It takes you into the sidebar here. It starts off on the series options. But if you come across here and go to the fill and line, under the line settings, it currently says no line, but you can choose a solid line or a gradient line or an automatic line and choose your color and all your other characteristics down here. So you might decide, for example, to have a dotted line, okay, or a dashed line or a solid line or a thick line, and you can change all those things down here. Let's switch across to the other set of data. So here we have an extra column of data. We've got the opening stock price, the highest and lowest that it was throughout the day, and the closing stock price. So again, I'm going to select my starting range here, just a week's worth of data to start with. Go to the Insert tab, go to the Stock Price chart, and choose the second option. Now, because the data is set up differently, it gives us a bit more information on the chart itself. Let me just move this, so I'll just resize it so we can see it. So what you have is a similar system with your candlesticks showing the price range throughout the day, but the block in the middle, rather than just showing a square or a diamond, as in the closing price, it shows you the opening and closing price. Now, where it's got a white marker here, that means the price rose throughout the day, so it closed higher than it opened. The black markers indicate that the price lowered throughout the day, so it opened higher than it closed. To change any of these options, you can either right-click and choose Format on the context menu, or you can double-click here, and it opens up the appropriate options in the panel if you've got it open, or you can switch to these options anywhere in the panel. You just do that by clicking this option here and choosing the element you want to work with. So here, in the drop-down list, we have series open, series high, series low, series close, and each of those can be set. In the list here, we have a couple of options called down bars one and up bars one. So you can actually change the white and the black settings here to any colors you like. If it ended lower, you might want to mark it red to indicate it went down. If it ended higher, you might want to mark it blue to indicate that it went up. And to do that, you just go to one of these. It brings up the options for that element that you've just selected. And let's say we just change the fill color. And because we're changing the up bar options, let me change that to a blue. If we change this option here to the down bar options, and maybe I'll set that fill color to a red. So now on here, you can see those changes being made. If you can't be bothered with all this stuff doing things manually, you can always use the preset options up in your chart styles section. And this gives you various looks and various designs. Some of these are pretty good. And even if there's not a perfect one, you may find there's one that's pretty close to what you want. Once you've set up everything the way you need it, if you want to expand the current data range, you can. So all you've got to do at any point is to go to your Chart Tools Design tab. Make sure you choose Select Data. It brings up the current data range that's being used. And the simplest way, rather than changing all these things individually, is just to reselect and include the new data range. So let's say we go 2 weeks worth of data and click OK. You can now see the candlesticks for 10 days rather than 5. Obviously, the more data you select, let's say we choose a month's worth of data here, the more data you choose, the more crammed it's going to be. That's just the nature of things. But don't forget, you can always move the chart to its own sheet, and that way it's full size or maximum size. And you do that by going to the Move Chart option over here. Make sure you choose New Sheet and give it a name. You've then got the full screen to play with. So if you follow Stocks and Shares, maybe download some data or input some data and just have a play around in Excel and see what you come up with. There's lots of options available for stock charts.